Hello crazy people, welcome back to my channel. This is Palak here. How you all are doing? I hope you all are doing well. And today I have come up with a very different topic which is gonna be totally different from the previous videos which you have seen on my channel. Today I'm gonna be talking about that what are the basic requirements to become a cabin crew. I know it is totally different because but if you have seen my last video, then you can connect it one after the other. But if you haven't seen my last video, then you can click the link below right here or the link in my description box so that you come to know that why I'm talking about this topic right now. So today this video is gonna be very informative for all the people who wanted to become a cabin crew from a long time and who are struggling one after the other for the interviews here and there. And even if you don't want to become a cabin crew, then also it will be good to you to listen to this topic so that you get some knowledge that really what are the basic requirements to become a cabin crew, and if you plan in future to become a cabin crew, so this will be helpful for you all. So let's start with the first point, which is the most important and the most basic requirement to become a cabin crew is this is a thing which you need to have at any point of time to become to come in the aviation field, because this is not something that you can earn very easily. I'm talking about the height. If you want to become a cabin crew, that you need to have a very good height. Why am I telling that height is the most important thing? Because at the age of 18 and 20, you can't gain height. Like, this is like what height you are having right now will only be there for your entire life. You can get knowledge, you can get qualification, you can gain weight, you can lose weight, but height is something which is you can't help at all. So that is the most important thing, that you have to have a proper height. What is the requirement of height for boys? It is minimum 170 centimeters, and for girls it is minimum 157 centimeters. So just keep in mind the limit, and sometimes it keeps on changing when you apply from one to another company. It keeps on changing from different to different companies. I'm just telling you the basic requirements. What are the average requirements for giving an interview? And when you switch companies, when you apply for one or other companies, then the requirements keeps on changing. So first is all about height, then second is about age. Like, what age should be there to apply as a cabin crew? Minimum is 18. Like, if you are at the age of 18, then you can definitely apply for a cabin crew interview, and you can pass all the rounds, whatever is there, and then you can just start your job. That's it. And 18 to 27 is the age criteria, because they don't take people more than 27 age. That is it. Then after that, I'll talk about qualification. Qualification is the most important thing, like I should say most easy thing, I should say, which you can get, because for becoming a cabin crew, you only need to be 12th pass. So any person who has completed the school, high school, everything, then he or she can become a cabin crew at any point of time. Even after completing your exams, you can just go and give the interview and find that if you can become a cabin crew or not. And even if you don't find yourself more confident, then you need to join some kind of academy or something. But that if it has came out the word academy, so I wanted to mention it, that to become a cabin crew, it is not important to join any of the academy. The basic requirements are that you should be fluent in English and Hindi, you should be having a good height and weight, and lastly you should be 12th pass. And age criteria is also there. Other than that, there is no requirement to go through any kind of training, any kind of academy, because all these academies who all are there, who just promise you to get the job, they all trained you for getting good personality, getting good communication skills, nothing else. Everything else, just to become a cabin crew, you will only learn when you pass through all the interviews, all the interview rounds, and then you when you get selected in one company, that company will teach you all the trainings and everything. 3 to 4 months is the time period for that training, that I'll tell you in some other videos. So it is not at all required to join any of the academy if you are 12th pass. You know how to speak, you know how to give interviews, you know how to communicate, then you can definitely go through any of the interviews that are coming up. Now after that, I'll talk about the medicals. The person who wants to apply for the cabin crew interview, who wants to get selected as a cabin crew, needs to be a medically fit person, because when you walk around the cabin, when you operate flights, then you represent a company, you just represent the status of the company. So none of the company will take any of the person who is disabled. So it is very much important thing that you should be mentally and physically fit to join as a cabin crew. And even they have one round for the medicals also, in which you go through all the medicals, and then you come to know that you are medically fit or not. After medical, I have a point about the language. Language is simply like English and Hindi. You don't need to know any additional language as you're applying for a domestic airline. So they just want a person to be fluent in English and Hindi, nothing else. After that, marital status needs to be unmarried. And medically fit. Plus, I'll talk about that you should not have any kind of scars or tattoos on your face and hands, most probably, like what is visible after wearing the company's attire, after wearing the company's uniform. There should be no visible tattoos or scars. And even if you have some scar on your face or hand or something, then you should know how to conceal it. If you can conceal it well, and you can just go to get the interviews and none of the person can make it that you have some scar or something, then it's totally fine. Then the company will not reject you at any point of time. But that mark should be completely concealed. Now, next I will talk about what are the important documents that you need. One is Aadhaar card, PAN card and passport. Even if you don't have passport, then at least you should have applied for it when you're going for the interview, so that you can tell the person that I have applied for it and I'll get it around 1 month, 15 to 20 days or 1 month it takes to get a passport. So these are all the important documents. So that's it. All these points which I have talked about is only the requirement to go and give any kind of interview. I'll just summarize it up in a very short manner. One is the qualification. You need to be 12th pass. Second thing is the height. Most important, you should complete the criteria of the height. Third is age limit. Fourth is medically, you need to be medically fit. All these 4 points, and that's it. You are done, and you can go for the interview. Other than that, scars, tattoos, documents, all the things that you need to manage on your own. But all these 4 to 5 things are only the basic requirements to become a cabin crew. So if you have any kind of query, and if you want to ask me anything, then you can just tell me in the comment section below, so that I can come to know that what you are expecting from me. I can make more videos about that. That's it. So bye-bye for now. I'll be coming in my next video. Bye-bye till then. Stay happy, stay connected, and do as much as musti as you can. Kyunki life toh ek baar hi milti hai. Bye-bye.